Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So today I am going to start exercise 7.4 of class 12th chapter number 7 integrals. We are going to discuss the questions number 17 to 21. But before that, those who have not watched our previous video regarding the solutions and what are the methods that we have to do for solving the integral of the type 1 upon quadratic equation or linear upon quadratic equation, please see my video. The description is given in the description link. You can just click over there to see the full solution of the questions also and the tricks that we have to follow to solve these type of questions. So without wasting the time, let's start now. So this is question number 17. You can see here that we have to do the integration of x plus 2 upon square root of x square minus 1. So first thing you observe is that we are having a linear equation in the numerator and a quadratic equation in the denominator. So what to do? We can do one step also by simplifying it in a simple manner. You can separate the integral into two parts. So we get x upon square root of x square minus 1 dx plus 2 is a constant, so you can take it outside, and this can be written as 1 upon x square minus 1 dx. Now for the first integral, this is very simple, that you can see that in the square root we are having a quadratic equation and the derivative of this is given in the numerator. So why not to put it is equal to t square, because I told you in all my videos, whatever is there in the square root, I am putting not t, but it is equal to t square. But I am telling you that you can do by putting x square minus 1 is equal to t also. But just for the simplification or to simplify in a very simplified process, I am going to put x square minus 1 is equal to t square. So let's see now. Let x square minus 1 is equal to t square in this integral only. Now differentiating both sides with respect to x. So I am getting 2x dx and this is 2t dt. Sorry, we are not differentiating with respect to x. We are only differentiating both sides. So here variable is x. So I am differentiating with respect to x. And here I have differentiated with respect to t. Cancelling 2 on both sides, I get x dx is equal to t dt. Now substituting the value of x dx in the given equation, I get t dt upon root of this t square becomes t, and this is actually the integration of the form 1 upon root x square minus a square. And you know that all the formulas I have discussed in the particular form, some particular forms of the integral. So those who have not watched that video regarding the derivation of those all six particular formulas, they can watch that video. The description is also given in the description box. You can just see over there to know how to find out the derivation of those six particular integrals. So we are just using the formula here. So t will be cancelled by t and we get 1, and the integration of 1 with respect to t is t, and it is actually the integral of the form integration of under root of x square minus a square, which is equal to log of x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. Finally, don't forget to put the value of t from here. From here, the value of t is square root of x square minus 1. So putting the value of t is equal to square root of x square minus 1 plus 2 log under root of x plus square root of x square minus 1 plus c. So this is our final answer. Please note down. So students, next is question number 18. This is integration of 5x minus 2 upon 1 plus 2x plus 3x square. So please just correlate with the previous question. In the previous question also, we are having a linear equation and a quadratic equation in the denominator. But one thing you have to remember, when we have split the integral into two parts, in the first integral, we are having a function in the denominator and its derivative in the numerator. But if I will do the same process in this question, I will not be able to get the derivative of the denominator in the numerator. As you can see, the derivative of the numerator will be going to be 6x plus 2. So if I am going to separate this, I am not able to get 6x plus 2 in the denominator. So we are going to use the process of finding the integral of linear upon quadratic form. So what to do? Please see the steps. So I told you in my video also in the introduction of the videos, I have given how to find out the integration of this type of question, where we are having a linear equation in the numerator and a quadratic equation in the denominator. So the very first step is that we have to take linear equation is equal to a times derivative of this quadratic equation plus b. This step is same for all type of questions. Whatever the linear equation we are having in the numerator or whatever the quadratic equation we are having in the denominator, the process is going to same to be same. Always you have to take linear equation is equal to a times derivative of quadratic equation plus b. It hardly matters whether the quadratic equation is in square root or without square root. The process is going to be same for both type of questions. So now see here, 5x minus 2 is equal to a times the derivative of this equation will be, the derivative of 1 is going to be 0 and 2x is 2 and this is 3 into 2 is going to be 6x plus b. Now what you have to do, you have to open it and comparing the coefficients of x and constant term. When you will open it, you get 6ax. First of all, I am writing the term containing x, and after that I will write down the constant term. Constant term are here 2a plus b. So by comparing the coefficients, what do I get when we will compare the coefficients? By comparing the coefficients, that means I have to compare the coefficient of x. Here I am having 5 and here the coefficient of x is 6a. So here I get the value of a is equal to 5 by 6. This is going to be 5 by 6. And if I will compare the constant term with the constant term here, I get 2a plus b is equal to minus 2. Now you just have to put the value of a is equal to 5 by 6 here. So putting this value of a, I am going to solve the value for b also. 2 I can cancel by 6, 3. So b is going to be minus 2 and 5 by 3 will be shifted to the right hand side and it will become negative. So b is going to be minus 6 minus 5, that is minus 11 by 3. So here till now I have just solved the value of a and b. Now I will use this value of a and b in this equation. So I get 5x minus 2 is equal to, you can use here using equation 1. 5x minus 2 is equal to a. What is a here? I am having 5 by 6 into 2 plus 6x, and what is b here? That is minus 11 by 3. Now substituting the value of numerator in the given integral, what do we get? I get, so given integral becomes, given integral becomes, this is quite lengthy type of question. You have to just put the value of numerator in the question. It becomes 5 by 6 into 2 plus 6x minus 11 by 3 upon the same quadratic equation. Now when you will do this process in every question, what do you observe? Actually, when you will split the first integral, you can take the constant outside, and in the numerator you will always get the derivative of the denominator. And second, see here, I can take 5 by 6 constant outside, so it becomes 2 plus 6x dx upon 1 plus 2x plus 3x square minus 11 by 3 integration of 1 upon 1 plus 2x plus 3x square dx. So you can observe here that in the first integral I am having the function and its denominator, but in second equation I have to apply the rule of the quadratic equation. How to solve the quadratic equation? We are going to follow the same process for that also. So please remember this thing, whenever you are going to solve this equation, you will always get first integral in the form of f dash x upon fx and the second equation in the form of 1 upon quadratic equation. Remember this thing. Second thing which I want to tell you, that when you have solved the value of a and b, just you have to waste your 1 second or 2 second to check whether your value of A or B is correct or not. I'm just telling you, in the exam, in the board exam, please verify whether solving this equation you are going to get again the numerator or not. So just say, see within 1 second, you can cancel. When you will open this, you can cancel 2 by 6. It is going to be 5 by 3 plus 6 will be cancelled by 6. So 5 into x is going to be 5x minus 11 by 3. Now 5 by 3 minus 11 by 3 is going to be minus 6 by 3. And all of you know that minus 6 by 3 is equal to minus 2. So it is going to be minus 5x minus 2, which is again the same numerator. So it's better to do the question further. First of all, you have to check whether the value of A and B satisfies the same equation. That means after solving this equation, you are going to get the same numerator or not. So this is the point you have to remember. Now moving on further, in the first integral, as I told you that always you get a function and its derivative. So what do I do? I will put this function as t. So its derivative is there. Dx is equal to dt. It is the derivative of 2x is going to be 2 and the derivative of 3x square is going to be 6x. Dx is equal to dt, which is there in the numerator. So substituting the value of 2 plus 6x dx is equal to dt by t. And what do I do here? This is actually the form of quadratic equation. So what I have to do, I have to follow the complete square method that I have done in my previous video also. So the first step for that is that you have to make the coefficient of x square is equal to 1. But here the coefficient of x square is equal to 3. So you have to take first of all 3 common. Now x square, the coefficient of x square will become 1 and it becomes 2 by 3x plus 1 by 3. In the next step, I have solved this first integral, so I get the integration of 1 by t is going to be log t minus 11 by 3 into 3 is going to be 9, integration of 1 upon x square plus 2 by 3x plus 1 by 3. Now I told you what to do to make a complete square. We always have to add and subtract half the coefficient of x whole square. So what is the coefficient of x here? 2 by 3. When we will half it, it become 1 by 3. See, 1 by t into 2 by 3 is going to be 1 by 3. So that means I have to add and subtract 1 by 3 whole square. Now, putting the value of t here, the value of t is 1 plus 2x plus 3x square. And as you have integrated it, this, so please write down here constant of integration, that is c1, minus 11 by 9, 1 upon, now I told you the shortcut method, just write down here x and whatever the term you have added and subtracted, you have to just take that number 1 by 3 whole square. Plus and minus depend upon the coefficient of x. If it is in minus, then you have to use the minus sign, and if it is in plus, then you have to use the plus sign. And the remaining terms are this. Better to solve it in the rough work. You can see here 1 by 3 minus 1 by 9. So taking the LCM, I get 3, and 3 divided by 9 is going to be 3. 3 into 1 is 3 minus 1 is going to be 2 by 9. So I get 2 by 9, which can be written as root 2 upon 3 whole square. I hope that all of you know that why I have just changed this equation in the form of x square plus a square, because you have to use the form of particular functions, integration of some particular functions which all are in the form of x square plus a square or x square minus a square. So here I have changed this complete equation in the form of x square plus a square, and now it's time to just apply the formula. And I hope that you remembered the formula. The integration of 1 upon x square minus a square is 1 by a tan inverse x by a. So 1 by a is here root 2 by 3, and tan inverse, in place of x I am having x plus 1 by 3, in place of a I am having root 2 by 3. I just forget to write down here c1. And now I have integrated this term also. So I am having C1 and integrated this term also, so I'll get C2. In the next term, I'm going to put C1 plus C2 is equal to C, because we have to take always one constant of integration. So finally, 5 by 6 log of 1 plus 2x plus 3x square minus, this can be cancelled by 3. So 3 into root 2 becomes 3 root 2 tan inverse. Now in this step, you have to just take the LCM. When you will take the LCM, it is equal to 3. So 3 into x is going to be 3x plus 1. This LCM 3 will be cancelled by this 3 in the denominator. So I just get 3x plus 1 upon root 2 plus the constant of integration. So this is my final answer. Please note down. So students, next question is question number 19. The same steps you have to follow as you have done in the previous question also. So just see now. I am just solving this equation in the denominator. What do I get? If I will just open this equation, I will get x square minus 9x plus 20. Right, because we have to form in the we have to make the integral in the form of linear upon quadratic form. Now just use the previous method. We have to take linear equation is equal to a times derivative of denominator, that is quadratic equation, plus b. Here I told you that whenever the equation is in quadratic form, and whether it is without square root or with square root, you have to follow the same process for both. So 6x plus 7 is equal to a into, the derivative of this is going to be 2x minus 9 plus b. Now solving this 2ax minus 9a plus b, comparing the coefficients, I will get 2a is equal to 6, because here the coefficient of x is 2a and here the coefficient of x is 6. So here I get the value of a is equal to 6, 3, and the constant term is here minus 9a plus b, which is equal to the constant term, that is 7. Now put the value of a is equal to 3 here. So 3 into 9 is going to be 27 plus b is equal to 7. So that means I'm going to get the value of b is equal to 7 plus 27, that is 34. So now I have just solved the value of a and b. So putting this value of a and b in this equation, I get using in equation 1, I get 6x plus 7 is equal to, what's the value of a? It is equal to 3 into 2x minus 9. And what's the value of b? That is 34. Now I told you that you have to just waste your 1 second to check whether the value of a or b is correct or not. So just solve it. 3 into 2 is going to be 6x, same correct. 3 into minus 9 is going to be minus 27 plus 34. Now you know that minus 27 plus 34 is equal to 7, that means correct. This is the thing you have to check from this step here, because if it is incorrect, then you can just check your answer or you can do the correction in this step only. You don't need to do the whole question after that. Now use this value in the given integral. I get the given integral becomes, putting the value of 6x plus 7 is equal to this. So this is equal to 3 into 2x minus 9 plus 34 upon square root of x square minus 9x plus 20 dx. Now I told you that you have to separate both the integrals. So 3 can be taken outside, and 2x minus 9 upon square root of x square minus 9x plus 20 dx plus 34 is a constant, so you can take it outside and it can be written as 1 upon square root of x square minus 9x plus 20. See students, I told you that the steps are correct in same in every step. See, in every question, whenever it is in the form of linear upon quadratic, always you have to put this linear is equal to a times derivative in denominator plus b, then solve for a and b, then put the value of a and b in this equation. And always, what do you observe? That the first integral will become in the form of f dash x upon fx, and the second integral will be in the form of 1 upon quadratic equation. It doesn't matter that whether it is in square root or with square root, the steps are going to be same for both the equations. So now I know that what I have to do, as this is in the square root, so I am going to put x square minus 9x plus 20 is equal to t square. No need to explain, because I hope so that you have seen my previous video also. Whenever the function is in the square root, then instead of putting it is equal to t, I am putting it t square. I am telling you again and again, then you can do this question by putting this quadratic equation is equal to t also. Your answer will not be changed. But just to simplify it, I am putting it is equal to t square, because it is better to remove t square from the square root and it become t. And it is going to be 2t dt. So in the first integral, I have done this substitution. So the first integral become 3 into the value of 2x minus 9 into dx is going to be 2t dt. And when I will put the value of x square minus 9x plus 20 is equal to t square, now I am taking the benefit of t square, square will be cancelled by square root and I am going to get the t plus 34. Now in the second question, you know that what I am going to do. This is quadratic equation, so what we will do, we will apply complete square method. In complete square method, what I have to do, just half the coefficient of x. Here the coefficient of x is 9, so when I will half it, it become 9/2. So that means we have to add and subtract 9/2 whole square. So it becomes x square minus 9x plus 20 plus 9/2 whole square minus 9/2 whole square. That's it. T will be cancelled by t, 3 into 2 is going to be 6, and the integration of dt with respect, integration of 1 with respect to t, because 2 has been taken outside, so I get only 1 inside the integration, and the integration of 1 with respect to t is t plus the constant of integration, that is c1, plus 34 integration of 1 upon square root. Now no need to waste the time, x 9/2 whole square, just see the coefficient of x, it is in negative, so here we have to put the negative. Now better to solve it in the rough. I told you always you are left over with third term and fifth term in this equation, so solve it. 20 minus fifth term is 9/2 whole square, 9 square is equal to 81 and 2 square is equal to 4. Now it can be taken as 1, and the LCM of 1 and 4 is going to be 4. 4 into 20 is 80, 80 minus 81 is equal to minus 1/4, and all of you know that 1/4 can be written as 1/2 whole square. I think you understood, because always you have to change in the form of x square plus a square, or x square minus a square minus x square, whatever, matlab both the terms should be in the square. Now you have to just apply the formula. This is in the form of 1 upon root x square minus a square, and in the particular type of functions I have discussed what is the formula of this, but before that we have to substitute the value of t from here. So from here t is equal to square root of x square minus 9x plus 20. Using this value I am going to get x square minus 9x plus 20 plus c1 plus 34. The integration of this term is going to be log of x. In place of x, I am having x minus 9/2 plus under root of x square minus a square. So this is going to be x minus 9/2 minus 1/2 whole square plus the constant of integration c2. In the next step, this is going to be x square minus 6 into under root of x square minus 9x plus 20 plus 34 log x minus 9/2 plus. Now told you, when you will solve this equation, you will get again the same integral which is there in the starting. When you will solve it, you will get x square minus 9x plus 20, which again can be written as x minus 5 into x minus 4. So write down, it is in the form of x minus 5 into x minus 4. And now you know that c1 plus c2 can be taken as again c as the constant of integration. So this is our final answer. Please note down. So student, next question number 20, that is integration of x plus 2 upon square root of 4x minus x square. Now I'm not going to discuss the type of this integral, same 17, 18, 19, all questions are same. So let न्यूमरेटर दैट इज x प्लस टू इज इक्वल टू a टाइम्स डेरिवेटिव ऑफ डिनोमिनेटर दैट इज 4x माइनस x स्क्वायर प्लस b. सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी a इंटू द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस इज 4 माइनस 2x प्लस b. नाउ यू हैव टू जस्ट कंपेयर द कॉफिशियंट ऑफ x. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल राइट डाउन द टर्म कंटेनिंग x दैट इज माइनस 2ax प्लस 4a प्लस b. Now comparing the coefficients, you can write down here, comparing the coefficients, I will get minus 2a is equal to 1 because here the coefficient of x is equal to 1. So here we get the value of a equals to minus 1 by 2. And when I'll compare the constant term, I'll get 4a plus b equals to 2. So putting the value of a is equal to minus 1 by 2 here, 4 into minus 1 by 2 plus b equals to 2. So minus 2 plus b equals to 2. So b is going to be 2 plus 2, which is equal to 4. Now, using this value in given equation number 1, so equation 1 becomes, here equation 1 is x plus 2 is equal to a is minus 1 by 2 into 4 minus 2x plus b is 4. You can check after solving this, you'll get again this x plus 2. Now, using this value of x plus 2 in the given equation or given integral, I'll get minus 1 by 2 4 minus 2x plus 4 upon square root of 4x minus x square dx, which can be splitted into two parts, minus 1 by 2 integration of 4 minus 2x upon square root of 4x minus x square, and this 4 is a constant, so you can take it outside, and again 1 upon root 4x minus x square dx. Now, I told you in the previous question also, always the first integral is of the form f dash x upon fx. So put this 4x minus x square is equal to t. 4x minus x square equals to, sorry, t square, because in every question I am taking t square, whenever the function is in square root. Differentiating both sides, we get 4 minus 2x dx is equal to 2t dt. So now this integral becomes, if I will put this value in this, so I will get minus 1 by 2 integration of, this is 2t dt upon square root of t square will become t, and plus 4 integration of 1 upon. Now here this is quadratic equation, and 1 upon quadratic equation, you have to do the question by complete square method. For complete square method, the first step is that the coefficient of x square should always be equal to 1. But here, when you will observe that x square is not equal to minus 1, it is actually equal to minus 1. So what you need to do, you have to take negative sign common. Taking negative sign common, it becomes x square minus 4x. So I hope that all of you understood, it becomes x square minus 4x. Now in the same step, you can do, what is the coefficient of x? That is 4. So 4, if I will take the half of 4, that becomes 2. That means we have to add and subtract 2 square. So 2 square minus 2 square. Understood? I have done these things in the one step only. I have taken first of all negative sign common, and the coefficient of x is here 4, taking the half of 4, which is equal to 2, and the same process of complete square method, in which we have to add and subtract the half the coefficient of x square whole square. So I have added and subtracted 2 square. Now this t will be cancelled by t, and this 2 will be cancelled by 2. It generally becomes integration of 1 dt plus 4 integration of 1 upon square root minus of this, 3 terms will become x minus 2 whole square, right? And this can be written as minus 2 square, same as it is. In the next step, what you are going to get, the integration of 1 with respect to t is going to be t plus the constant of integration, that is c1, plus 4 integration of 1 upon. Now you know that in a particular type of integration, we are not having any formula of the integration of type 1 upon square root of minus of x square minus a square. So better to shift this minus sign again inside the bracket. So I will get this term as positive and this term as negative. Okay, first of all, you have to observe whenever that coefficient of x square is negative and the function is in square root, you have to take negative sign inside the square root. You can't take negative sign outside because it becomes actually root 7 iota. Fine. So you can't take, whenever the term is in negative, you can't take negative sign outside the square root. So it will remain inside and all the terms will get be changed. The sign will get changed. X square becomes positive and 4x become negative. In the same step you can do half the coefficient of x whole square, add and subtract. Now it becomes the identity of x minus 2 whole square and it becomes minus 2 square. Now shifting again back negative sign in this bracket, I'll get 2 square minus of x minus 2 whole square. So replacing the value of t from here, from this point, I get t is equal to 4x minus of x square. T is equal to square root of 4x minus x square. So replacing the value of t is equal to 4x minus x square. Plus 4, I am not writing here C1 because C1 will be shifted with this C2. So I am writing down in the same step. This is actually the integration of the form 1 upon root of a square minus x square, which is equal to sine inverse x upon a plus c. So this is our final answer. Please note down. This is our final answer. I have taken the constant of integration C1 plus C2 as C. So student, next question number 21, that is integration of x plus 2 upon square root of x square plus 2x plus 3. Same steps we have to follow. Let this linear equation, that is x plus 2 is equal to a times derivative of this quadratic equation. This is x square plus 2x plus 3 plus b. So I hope that you have understood the basic concept of this form, linear upon quadratic. So this is going to be x plus 2 is equal to the derivative of x square is 2x and the derivative of 2x is 2 plus b. Now opening this we get 2ax plus 2a plus b. So by comparing the coefficients as we have done in our previous question also, in all questions we have to follow the same steps. By comparing the coefficients, here I get 2a is equal to 1. So from here I get the value of a equals to minus 1 by 2 and 2a plus b is equal to this constant term 2. Using the value of a is equal to 1 by 2, 2 will be cancelled by 2, so it becomes only 1. So if I will shift this b 1 and on the right hand side it becomes 2 minus 1 which is equal to 1. So here I have evaluated the value of a and b. Using this value in equation number 1, this is actually equation number 1. So using in equation 1, I get x plus 2 is equal to, the value of a is 1 by 2 into 2x plus 2 plus b is 1. You can check here also, answer also. If you will again open the bracket, 2 will be cancelled by 2, it becomes x, and 2 will be cancelled by 2, it becomes 1, and 1 plus 1 is going to be 2. So I told you that you can check your answer before proceeding the question. Now x plus 2, using this value of x plus 2 in the given integral, I get half of 2x plus 2 plus 1 upon square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. Now splitting this integral into two parts, as you know, then the first part I am going to get f dash x upon fx and in the second integral I am going to get 1 upon form of the quadratic equation, 1 upon square root of x square plus 2x plus 3 dx. Fine. Now all of you know that in this integral, what do we have to do? We have to take x square plus 2x plus 3 is equal to t square, as in square root. So I am taking t square. So now 2x plus 2 dx is equal to 2t dt. By differentiating this, so we get 2x plus 2 dx is equal to 2t dt. Using the value of 2x plus 2 into dx is equal to 2t dt in this equation, what do I get? I get half of this 2t dt. I get half of the value of 2x plus 2 dx is equal to 2t dt upon square root of t square will become t. So better to write down it t. And in the second integral, this is of the form 1 upon quadratic equation, and we have to follow the method of complete square method. So here the coefficient of x is 2, and if I will add and subtract half the coefficient, so half of the coefficient of x is 1, so I will add 1 square and subtract 1 square. So finally 2 will be cancelled by 2 and this t will be cancelled by t. So I am left over with 1 only, and the integration of 1 with respect to t is going to be t plus again the constant of integration c1 plus integration of 1 upon this becomes x plus 1 whole square. I am using plus sign because the coefficient of x is in plus. And the leftover is 3 minus 1, which is going to be 2, and 2 can be written as root 2 whole square. So now you have changed this quadratic equation in the form of x square plus a square, and this is in square root. So the form, replacing the value of t from here, that value of t is going to be square root of x square plus 2x plus 3. So this is x square plus 2x plus 3. Plus the integration of this term 1 upon x square plus a square is log of x plus under root of x square plus a square, that is root 2 square, plus again I am telling you the constant of integration c1, plus here I have integrated c2, so c1 plus c2 can be taken as c. Now it becomes x square plus 2x plus 3 plus log x plus 1, please write down in this bracket, x plus 1 plus, when you will solve this equation, again you will get the same term which is you are having in the starting of the question, that is x square plus 2x plus 3. You can solve it also by opening the x plus 1 whole square by using the formula. You get x square plus 1 plus 2x and root 2 is 2. So 1 plus 2 is going to be 3. Again you get the same equation. So no need to waste the time. Please write down whatever the question is there in the starting. This is your answer. Please note down. Students, I hope so that you have understood all the questions discussed in this video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes.